Hey guys, and welcome to another video. So in today's video, we're going to check out a brand new robot that I made. So this is an obstacle avoiding robot, and let me tell you what it is primarily used for. So what I think that this robot could be used for is a firefighter's assistant, more like a robot that you send inside a burning building before the firefighter himself goes inside, alright? Let me explain. So let's imagine a scenario happening right now, alright? There's a cotton mill or some factory burning inside. You can extinguish the fire easily from the outside using water, but the fumes are still a problem. The smoke, the carbon dioxide, it's very thick and it's still going to take some time for it to completely disappear and go outside. So at that moment, you cannot see what's inside. You're totally blind because of the smoke. It's very thick, alright? So it will be dangerous for the firefighters to go inside and look for survivors in that thick smoke. You cannot use a camera because it's thick. You can't see anything. You can't use an infrared sensor either because infrared sensors use heat signatures, and that won't really work in a fire situation. So the best solution for that is sound. So this is an ultrasonic sensor, and as you can see, it has two cylinders that look like robotic eyes. So it looks pretty cool, so I chose it. So one cylinder is a transmitter and the other one is the receiver. So the transmitter sends out high frequency sound waves that are way higher than the decibel range for humans, so you cannot hear the sound waves that it produces. So what's special about this high frequency sound waves is that it'll travel through anything that is gaseous. So no matter if it's thick smoke or carbon monoxide or carbon dioxide, no matter how thick it is, it'll pass right through it. But if a solid object comes in front of it, it'll hit the object and get reflected back. And the reflected sound waves will be absorbed by the receiver. So that's what the receiver is for. So through this process, the sensor is able to find out the exact distance between the sensor and the object, the solid object that the sound waves actually hit. So this is because the sound waves that we just transmitted, they travel at the same velocity through a specific medium. Alright, so before talking more about the Arduino board, the drivers, the motors and the circuits and everything, let me just show you a demonstration of what actually happens.
Alright, so this is the robot itself, and as you can see, there's an ultrasonic sensor right on top of the servo motor right there. That's the servo right there. And as you can see behind it, there's a LiPo battery that actually powers the 12 volt motors that I'll be showing you a little later. And then there's a power bank, there's a 10,000 milliamp power bank. You definitely will not be needing a power bank that is this big in capacity, but this is all that I have. So this is what I had to use. And that is used to power the Arduino and the motor drivers and everything. So I know it looks a little bit dirty and too complex. Let me just try to show you a little bit detailed. So as you can see, the blue color circuit board right there, that's the Arduino Uno board. This red color one is the motor driver. So what that does is it converts the 5 volt output from the Arduino to the 12 volt input for the motors. That's a mini breadboard that I've used to just split the power supply. And that's the main switch for controlling the motors. And let me just show you what's underneath. As you can see, there are four different motors. I've shorted out the right side motors and the left side motors. As you can see, that's the wire right there. I've shorted these two motors out and these two motors out. So I can control four motors with the power of two. Now let me just show you a demonstration of how it actually works. So as you can see, I've connected the wire to the actual Arduino board, and now all I have to do is start the power bank. So the power bank is on, and now I will be using the switch on the side to turn on the battery. So I've coded it in such a way that if it senses any object within 20 centimeters from the sensor, it will just stop, it will go in reverse, and then it will use the servo motor to look around if there's any objects on the sides. If there's no objects on any side, they'll just go around and take the left and go around the object. Nothing hurts, no kid.
Alright, so hopefully you guys saw that and understood, because the motors that I used were a little bit too fast. It was like 300 RPM. And the best results would be achieved when you have like 30 RPM or like 50 RPM. It would be better if it's lower. The slower it is, the better. Alright, so this is the robot itself. Hopefully you can see it. So this is the ultrasonic sensor that is on top of a servo motor, alright? So as soon as it turns on the switch, it keeps going forward, right? It keeps going forward as long as there's no object in front of it. And as soon as it senses an object within 20 centimeters before the sensor, it stops and it takes a reverse, alright? And then it uses the servo motor up in front. It just looks right and then looks left to see that if there are any objects on the right side and any objects on the left side. If there are objects on the right side, it'll go left side. If there are any objects on the left side, it'll just take a right turn. And if there aren't any objects anywhere, it'll just automatically take a right turn. That's how I've coded it. So please try and make sure that you actually do this project, because I'm pretty sure this is an easy project for everyone to try it out. And it's a very good final year project if you're doing engineering or college or whatever. There are a bunch of links in the description below where you could just follow the step-by-step instructions from Instructables or my website or wherever that you like. So hopefully you'll make this on your own. So please make sure you subscribe, because there are a lot more projects that are coming up. I've already made a ton of projects, but I just haven't filmed them. So that those are coming up. So stay tuned for that. And if you like this video, like it. If you don't like it, dislike it. Don't forget to comment down below what you'd like to see next in my future videos. And hopefully you enjoyed. Thank you so much for watching, and see you guys next time.